Hey there everyone, welcome back to another video on Tuber Gaming. With the official release date nearing, MotoGP 21 has been making quite a lot of headlines. Everyone who is into motorsports is talking about what to expect with the upcoming release. And in order to answer all your queries, here we have a detailed discussion on this topic. So, if you wish to know more, search no further and tag along. Before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Alright, now let's begin. MotoGP 21 is planned to get released on the 22nd of April, 2021. And it will be made available on almost all of the gaming consoles available out there, ranging from PS4 and PS5, as well as Xbox One, Xbox Series X/S, Nintendo Switch, and PC via both Steam and Epic Game Store. This practically means that Milestone Gaming, basically the people behind MotoGP 21, have left no one behind, and they wish to get in everyone on board with them. This would not be the first time they do this, but it surely matters a lot for the people who wait desperately for further updates and releases of MotoGP games. Speaking of desperation, since the release of the game is not far away, it raises the question of whether the game actually deserves the full price it's going to be sold at, or whether it happens to be just a simple update from the previous years. Many game developers have scammed their users by skipping out on major changes, and they're able to do that by simply rebranding the components of the game. Many naive gamers fall into the trap of successful marketing, which ends up bearing a substantial cost to them. And it's not only about the money, it's also about the cost of time involved. Gamers could have also played something more worthwhile, but fingers crossed, all we can hope for is that MotoGP 21 does not disappoint us by repeating the same old components, and that it actually brings forth stuff that is new and innovative. The people behind the creation of the game MotoGP 21 claim that the game is now bigger and better than ever. There are three particular changes brought that are being highlighted the most by the developers, which include a new progressive and strategic managerial career mode, an updated and upgraded neural AI, and some major gameplay improvements to make the game more immersive and fun for the players. Speaking of the new managerial career, on and off deck, the latest version of Managerial Career introduces several new elements. Without a doubt, the secrets to success are assembling the right team and customizing the bike. And it seems that the developers have understood that now. The managerial team is supposed to have a personal manager who would lead the staff, help writers with his domain to look for new contracts, and so much more. Apart from the personal manager, increased research points, won weekly or during free practice sessions, are the goal of the chief engineer. Meanwhile, the data analyst is responsible for finding the ideal balance for each development field to advance, resulting in the most comprehensive and in-depth professional experience imaginable. Furthermore, the AI system used in the game that goes by the name Anna is being reintroduced in the game, where it is said that Anna is going to have some major improvements, resulting in the creation of much faster and realistic opponents ever. The developers claim that the gaming experience will now be equivalent to a real race, but I guess we will be the judge of that when the game actually releases. Speaking of realistic games, graphics play a vital role in making a game look real. And as we get to see in the video shots of the game, there is a massive improvement in this department as well. Well, MotoGP always had impressive graphics, but this one seems even more special. There are several big changes coming to the gaming experience as well. For instance, the bike retrieval sequence is being introduced, where it is being said that if you fall anytime, you won't be respawned automatically on the same course anymore. You'll need to get back on your bike as quickly as possible on your own. Additionally, brake temperature along with tire temperatures are being introduced. The trick to keeping the situation under control is to keep an eye on the temperature of your brakes. They risk losing their potency if their temperature gets out of balance. Apart from that, the system of long lap penalty is being introduced. This means that if you were to make blunders like start off before the race actually starts, or the stuff of that sort, you will properly get penalized. A message would appear on the top of your vehicle that would inform you of the penalty you get for your actions. Also, the animations we get to see have also changed. Generally speaking, the game has been refurbished quite enormously, with everything made better, ranging from the sound system to the menus we get to use. So it is safe to say that the game will not disappoint its users. But we will get extra sure when the game actually comes out on the 22nd. Well, this brings us to the end of our video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you haven't liked the video yet, do so. It's never too late. Give it a thumbs up, people. We'll soon see you in another video. Until then, take care and goodbye.